We're going to talk about validating your IAM policies with AWS CloudFormation hooks. And the first thing that we're going to talk about is, what are CloudFormation hooks? So CloudFormation hooks are preventative controls that run before a CloudFormation resource create, update, or delete. So when you create a CloudFormation hook, you choose the resources in your template that you want, or the resource types, I should say, that you want that CloudFormation hook to run against. And then your CloudFormation hook will inspect the configuration of your resources at provisioning time. This provisioning time piece is really important here. Traditionally, this is done by pointing a command line tool at static templates. But the problem here is that those static templates can contain things like functions and variables. When we analyze a CloudFormation stack or a CloudFormation resource at deployment time, we get to see what the values are for those resources immediately before we actually go to deploy them. And then we can prevent our non-compliant resources from being deployed. One other thing to note, with CloudFormation hooks, you can centrally enforce these controls rather than having to find each and every one of your CI/CD pipelines in your organization to embed those command line tools in. All right. So what does this look like in practice? We have an author of a CloudFormation template. Now that author makes a create stack call. CloudFormation hooks will intercept that create stack call and invoke a Lambda function. This CloudFormation hook is really just a Lambda function that returns a compliant or a non-compliant result for each resource of that given resource type that you configured in your hook. So if the resource is non-compliant, if any resource is non-compliant, the create stack call fails, and your stack rolls back. If all resources are compliant, that create stack call succeeds, and your resource is deployed to your environment, your stack is deployed to your environment. This also works for the AWS CDK, if your users are the AWS CDK, which just deploys CloudFormation stacks behind the scenes. So what is IAM Access Analyzer policy validation? You can use policy validation. This is a feature of IAM Access Analyzer that you can use to validate your IAM policies against IAM grammar and best practices. It'll tell you things like your policy is not syntactically correct, it just will never work. It'll also tell you things like your policy is over permissive and you're potentially allowing too many permissions. You have a missing condition key for that specific action, and that's a security problem. There are over 130 checks available today, and the Access Analyzer team is constantly adding new ones. Findings from Access Analyzer are classified into four separate types. There's error findings, which effectively means that your policy is just not going to work. You should absolutely fix error findings. There's security warnings. These are also typically things that you should fix, but they mean things like your policy is over permissive, you missed that condition key that's important for a specific action. And then there are warnings and suggestions. Suggestions being at the lowest level of severity, and they're like the nice to haves, like you should probably do this. So there's actually an API for policy validation called Validate Policy. If you've never programmatically called that API, you've probably used policy validation if you've ever used the policy editor or one of the policy editors in the AWS console. If you can see this thing at the bottom, I'm not sure if that's large enough, but what that is that that's policy validation, that's Access Analyzer policy validation behind the scenes in real time as you're editing your policy. It's telling you the things that are right and wrong with your IAM policy. In this case, it's telling me that S3 list buckets doesn't actually exist. The real action is S3 list all my buckets. So you can see the types of things that policy validation can give you if we were to put it in front of our deployments. So let's take these two concepts and combine them. Let's build an Access Analyzer policy validation hook that validates the resources in my template that have IAM policies. And what that allows us to do is that allows us to help prevent these bad IAM policies, these erroneous IAM policies, these over-permissive IAM policies from getting into our AWS environment. So how does that work? Like I said, when you create a CloudFormation hook, you specify the resource types that it's going to run against. So we're going to select resource types that have IAM policies, whether they're identity policies, whether they're resource-based policies. and we're going to parse those IAM policies from our CloudFormation template. We are going to get those policies in that Lambda function that I talked about, and we are going to make a call to Access Analyzer's policy validate policy API. And that validate policy API is going to return findings for those policies. And we're going to look at those findings, and we're going to say, are those findings okay? Are there no findings? Are the findings that we get, are they okay? And either fail or let the deployment succeed, depending on those findings. One other thing that you can do with CloudFormation hooks is you can add your own configuration. And this is really your API to your CloudFormation hook. So there's always exceptions, but we want to have the ability in our CloudFormation hook to use configurable roles to say whether a finding should allow or should fail the deployment or whether it should successfully allow the deployment to continue. So what this looks like in practice, again, we have our CloudFormation template author. That CloudFormation template author makes that same create stack call. We intercept that create stack call with our hook, which again is just a Lambda function. And remember, this is happening for each resource of a given resource type that we configured in our CloudFormation hook. We make that call to validate policy, and validate policy returns findings of those various severity types. And we determine if they're blocking or not. What we mean by blocking is, should that policy or should that finding fail our deployment, or should we allow the deployment to continue? So if we find some have some findings that are blocking, we fail the deployment. Otherwise, we deploy the resource, that same idea that you saw with just the generic hooks. Okay? Does that make sense to everyone? Okay. So how do we actually build a CloudFormation hook? This is the really rough four steps. We do have documentation out there in CloudFormation to show you how to do this. But your first step is really define the resource types that your hook should run against. And in our case, we want them to run against anything that has an IAM policy in it. We're going to implement our AWS Lambda function. This is really the meat of the work that you're going to do here. And this is that function that's going to make that call to validate policy and or do whatever you want it to do. You could imagine any other type of hook that you'd want to build in this area. You're going to take your hook and you're going to register it. When you register that hook, it then becomes available in your account to configure and to turn on to run against your CloudFormation deployments. And then you'll do the actual configuration. And this configuration is what actually turns that hook on. If you operate in an AWS organization, you might have many accounts that you want to run this hook against. You can use CloudFormation stack sets to actually deploy this hook across your organization and register it and configure it. All right, I'm going to switch screens here real quick, and we're going to walk through a quick demo of a CloudFormation hook that I have built to do this. Can everyone sort of see this? Okay, I don't think it's going to get much bigger. All right, so we're going to start with a pretty straightforward template that has an IAM role, and it has an IAM policy. Both of these policies have no problems with them, and I've already deployed this template in my account. When you do the template deployment, if you're familiar with this events page, you'll see when there is a hook, there's a new column that says hook invocation. In that hook invocation column, you can see that my hook's been invoked for both my policy, and if I click on it, I can see the note that says the hook completed successfully, that there are no policy validation findings, my policy is good to go. And remember I said that these hooks run for every resource in your template that matches that specific resource type. So in this case, I ran it for both my role and my policy. Roles have a trust policy that I'm also, or which is effectively a resource-based policy that I also want to validate. And you can see here, the hook also succeeded. So two separate invocations, one for each resource. Now the more interesting scenario is when I create this CloudFormation stack, and I do have a policy that has findings. So here we see I've got an invalid policy. Let me just quickly show you what that looks like. So I've got, again, a template with a role and a policy. And I've got a couple actions here that just don't exist. So we expect policy validation to return some error. And if I go back to my events, scroll down to my hook invocation column, I can see here that instead of that hook deployment, hook invocation succeeded, I get this hook complete failed. And I've written this hook in a way that it said that it lists the most severe findings here, given the limited space that we have, and then it'll write the rest of the findings out to the logs, which I'll show you in a second. So here you can see that that policy is just not going to work, so I want to stop this stack from even getting into my environment in the first place. I'm going to totally fail my deployment just because this policy validation hook intercepted that create stack call. So I mentioned configuration. In your CloudFormation registry, you have this activated extensions link over here where you can access your hooks and you can access your configuration as well. This is roughly what the configuration looks like for the hook that I created. These top two properties up here, target stacks and failure mode, those come with all hooks. So your options for targeting stacks is you can target all stacks in your account. That's saying, when should my hook run? And I want it to run against every stack that someone's deploying to my account. Your options are really all or none. So this is really the on-off switch for your hook. And then your failure mode. Now, there are two options for failure mode as well. You can fail or you can warn. Warning could be really useful if you just, if you're not quite ready to block deployments, not quite ready to make stacks roll back based on these findings, you want to do some testing, or you just want to do some log analysis. Maybe your hook just logs some details to CloudWatch, and then you can aggregate those logs elsewhere and do analysis on what's being deployed to your environment. So there's some really interesting things you can do with that warn failure mode. But for me, in my environment, I want any stack that has findings to fail. Now, I mentioned with Access Analyzer policy validation those four severity levels. This is custom configuration that I had added to my hook that basically says that if I see findings of a specific severity level, I want to ignore them or not ignore them. In this case, I want to say ignore error. It's kind of a double negative there. Ignore error findings false. So I want error findings and security warnings to fail my create stack. I'm okay with warnings and findings. In that case, I'm just going to tell the hook to log those. Maybe I can do some analysis on those logs. And then I have this extra property here that says, okay, well, there's always these exceptions. Maybe I have this administrative role that I want to deploy permissive policies on purpose to my account. It needs the ability to get past this CloudFormation hook. So I've got this ignore findings with array here where I can set up all my exceptions. Okay? The other thing I wanted to show you is when these hooks run, what I did with my hook is I wrote to the logs. So this CloudFormation hook it'll print out that configuration when it starts. It'll also show me the exact call that it's making to the Validate Policy API. So you can see what this API looks like. You just pass in your policy. You say whether it's a resource policy or an identity policy. And then specific resource types sometimes have specific policy validation roles that Access Analyzer will run. And you can see here I've got no findings detected. So the hook invocation completes successfully. Now if I switch to that was the one that had findings. Now if I go down to my identity policy here, this is the identity policy that has those two IAM actions that just don't exist. I don't want these to get into my environment. It's kind of useless to have a non-working policy in my environment. So you can see here that the hook logged some details that the Access Analyzer policy validation API returned. This is roughly the API verbatim that the response from the API verbatim that you get when you call validate policy. So I've shown that kind of brief error message when you click that button in the CloudFormation UI, but then you can go to the logs and see some detailed errors. And again, you can ship this elsewhere and do analysis if you don't want to block based on this. You can do some really interesting stuff with hooks. Okay. That's it for the demo. So what else can you do with hooks? There's an infinite amount of possibilities that you can do with hooks, but specifically related to IAM policies, you could imagine doing some custom checks on your own IAM policies that are maybe are specific to your organization that wouldn't be supported in Access Analyzer Validate Policy today. So things like, okay, maybe I'm going to look at all resource-based policies and look at principles and make sure that the principles that my developers, my builders are putting in resource-based policies are principles that I'm okay with. Maybe if I'm using attribute-based access control, I can inspect tag keys and see if they're being used appropriately, see if I have the proper governance over those tag keys that are being used for attribute-based access control. You could also imagine kind of using these hooks as like an extension to a guardrail or a service control policy and saying, if I see a policy that has certain IAM actions, I'm just going to block your deployment. So maybe you're running into policy space constraints in certain areas, and you can kind of use CloudFormation hooks as a bit of an extension to that. So to summarize, the Access Analyzer policy validation hook that I showed you here can help ensure that your IAM policies are being validated before deployment. And again, I want to reiterate the big difference between CloudFormation hooks and something like a command line tool that runs against a static template is that all of those functions and variables and things are resolved. You are seeing the exact resource before it's deployed. Now, that doesn't mean that there's still not a kind of a world in which the CLI tools exist, or I would not, or I would recommend the CLI tools as well. I think that those can be used in conjunction. One of like the trade-offs that you have to make when you're using CloudFormation hooks is that it doesn't get run until provisioning time, which is very late in the process. So what you can do is you can run those command line tools in your CI/CD pipelines, run them on developer commits very early in the process, and then have your CloudFormation hooks act as that gate at deployment time. You can also use, you want to take advantage of CloudFormation hooks configuration when you're building hooks. That is your API to your CloudFormation hooks. You are always going to have exceptions to these controls, so think about what those exceptions will be and build that into your configuration when you build your CloudFormation hooks. And with that, thank you, and please complete the session survey in the mobile app.